So, how waterproof is the iPhone 7? And what kind of help can we expect from Apple if our phone does get wet? Let's open it up and find out. First off, it's important to remember that Apple never said that their phone is waterproof, just splash and water resistant. The terminology is very, very important, and I'll tell you why. The Apple iPhone 7 has an ingress protection of 67. The first number is talking about solids, like dust, and the second number is talking about liquids. A 7 at the end means the phone can be immersed in water shallower than 1 meter for short periods of time, much different than Samsung's IP68 rating that can be submersed in water deeper than 1 meter. The testing standards are different for each number. IP69 is the highest IP rating, which would be able to withstand steam jet cleaning. Here is one phone with an IP69 rating. So when compared to other water-resistant phones, Apple is at the lowest end of the immersion protection. The most important thing to remember from this whole video is that if your phone does get wet, it is not covered by any kind of warranty whatsoever. It is written pretty clearly on Apple's website, liquid damage not covered under warranty. There aren't many ingress points for water on the iPhone 7, especially since Apple got rid of that headphone jack. Apple saved a significant amount of money by removing that hole and not having to waterproof it. I'll be talking more in depth about that headphone jack in a future video, so buckle up for that. Let's start with the biggest hole in this phone. One you might not think of is the screen slot. The gap between the edge of the screen and the edge of the phone is the largest area that needs to be sealed. You can see the adhesive clearly when I did my bend test, and when I was removing the screen from the phone. This tacky black substance is water resistant and helps keep water and dust out of the phone. The second biggest hole is the charging port. Here is the port itself. It's got 6 different screws in close proximity to the port that hold it tight against the frame of the phone. The rubber ring around the tip helps keep water out, and the lightning port hole is sealed with this clear plastic. Each little component on the charging port ribbon is also protected by plastic. This is pretty smart. Just in case water does get inside the phone, the electronics close by the opening will still be protected. What about these two speaker holes at the bottom? The one to the right of the charging port is the loudspeaker hole. It has a thin mesh inside the exterior holes to keep water out, as well as a thin mesh inside the speaker itself. So there are 2 simple layers of protection. The left side of the charging port is a microphone hole, and this is still protected by the same type of waterproof mesh. It lets air and sound through. As long as the water pressure is minimal, liquid would rather stick to itself than pass through the small openings. Thumbs up for the sweet waterproof mesh. What about the earpiece? It is held tightly against the screen of the phone with several screws. A rubber seal around the front also helps keep water out, along with multiple layers of that same waterproof mesh. There is even mesh on the back of the speaker, just in case. So what is keeping water out of the side buttons? The power button internal housing is here, along the edge. I pop off these 2 screws, and normally there would be some kind of rubber sidewall between the button layers and the side of the phone, but it looks like Apple is just hoping that these really small holes work in their favor. If I remove the button entirely, each prong of the button has a little rubber washer on the tip, and that'll probably help keep water out, as long as it is extremely shallow water with no pressure. The SIM card tray has a loose-fitting little rubber ring around the edge of it. So how will Apple be able to tell if your phone has been wet? Right here on the motherboard is a water damage indicator. It looks all innocent and white when it's dry, but turns red the moment liquid touches it. The motherboard itself is not water resistant at all. Some electronics will be covered in a hydrophobic spray that repels water. Liquid would bead up and roll off without sticking to the board at all. But as you can clearly see from both water droplets here, the water is clinging very tightly to the motherboard, signaling that it is not treated with any hydrophobic coatings. So if water gets in, water will kill it. So if you use your iPhone as your daily device, I would strongly recommend that you still avoid water. Just think of that IP67 rating as an added layer of protection, a slight peace of mind. But do not trust it with regular liquid contact, and definitely keep it out of a hot shower. Steam gets into more places that regular water will not. And if your phone gets damaged, it is entirely your problem, and not Apple's. So what do you think? Do you trust Apple's water-resistant measures? If you want to see the slightly beefier water-resistant protections on the Note 7, go ahead and click the link up in the corner or down in the video description. Samsung even managed to waterproof their headphone jack. It's pretty interesting. Like always, my behind-the-scenes stuff is on Twitter and Instagram, so follow me there and you could be the first to see the high-end tech reviewed from the inside. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you around.